Now, I know there are a lot of myths about leadership, right? Well, under certain circumstances, yes, and under from a certain place you can lead and not from others. But it's not true. Leadership is not something that you're born with. Leadership is something that you choose. You choose to lead. The future isn't sitting somewhere waiting to unfold. We bring it to life. We bring it to life with every action that we take and each word that we speak. I've met people from all walks of life. And what I've discovered is that they're all hungry for something more, for some more meaning in life, for fun, for finding purpose. Yet I find many people are really convinced that extraordinary is available to only the chosen few. You know those chosen few, right? They were born with the magic dust. Some of us have it, some of us don't. And I think when we buy into that magic dust theory, it lets us off the hook because we can say we weren't on that line, right? We didn't get the magic dust, so we don't have to step up. We're off. Well, I'm here to tell you that extraordinary is available to each and every one of us. And it is never a matter of can you. It is always a matter of will you. It is a choice. So right now we're going to do something. How many people are sitting next to someone that they know? Oh, no. You're going to sit next to someone that you don't know, and you're going to meet them for breakfast tomorrow morning.
Any parents in the room? Couple? Well, I have a 16, 18, and 20-year-old sons, okay? So born 2 years apart. I started my business when they were a little baby, so I had 3 kids under 4 years old, completely insane. And I thought that my job was to walk around with a tablet with a checklist about how they would do the things that I wanted them to do, right? But leadership in that arena was really about how do I articulate a future for them, something that they see that is so powerful and so magical that they would want to take it on without my sitting on them for performance, right? Very different kind of leadership to inspire and elicit a certain action as opposed to bludgeoning it out of people. Of course, I learned that a little too late, but you know, all the kids have to pay a price. That's just how it goes. So one of the things that meant was that I would have to lead by example, right? How do you lead by example? Well, I would have to be joyful. I would have to be trustworthy, which would mean I'd have to do as I said, right? I would have to be a little less crazy, a lot more generous, a lot more fun, in integrity with myself. And guess what? They'd really know whether or not I was. And that would create leadership for me at home. I would suspect that it creates leadership for you wherever you are, in whatever situation you're in. So why would you choose to lead? Well, I think you only choose it if you want more power in your life, more passion, more joy, more vitality. It's about the choices that you can create for yourself and your family. Anyway, I've seen that, you know, the lead dog really does have a much better view than the pack that's in the back.